Hey guys, welcome to What Matters, where we do our best to keep you informed with what matters. We keep you up to date with the latest gaming news, tech, and how-to videos. So if you're interested in seeing more videos like these, make sure to subscribe. In today's episode of What Matters, we see some potential changes that hopefully increase the quality of life in Warzone. One of our well-known streamers, CourageJD, put out some requests that he felt would improve the game overall. He mentioned removing or refunding the Rosé skin, a functioning streamer mode, making bounties drop, consolidation loot when available, among one or two more ideas. It was great to see Raven reply back saying that there are a lot of changes coming soon that we will be happy about. They talk about adjusting Rosé instead of removing it, some significant weapons balancing, and a fix for Modern Warfare weapons perks and sniper glint. They did follow that up, letting us know that there should be some more surprises in the coming week, so we'll see what they bring us. On to some other news. It is rumored that NVIDIA DLSS might be coming to Warzone Season 3. DLSS is Deep Learning Super Sampling. It should increase performance like FPS and make lower resolutions higher at no cost to the performance in the game. It is currently in Black Ops Cold War, but it is for PC players only. For in-game, you will now see the nuclear radiation spreading across the map. Currently, it's at the ship, hospital, and prison. The zombies have moved from the superstore, and you can now go hang out with them at the dam. You can drop in at any location where there is radiation, but it'll kill you, and you'll lose your opportunity at the gulag. Only when playing in duos or more and have a teammate alive can you return as a zombie. And it was reported that as of this video going live, if you were a part of the Sales 630 nuclear bug ban wave, PC zombie players only, those accounts that were banned mistakenly have been restored per Treyarch. We have seen some tweets about the game-breaking glitch in Warzone making players invincible. But we have yet to experience this glitch. Be on the lookout. Not even Rosé can stop it. Also, Treyarch's second teaser premiered. Without any solid confirmation, we may be looking at a rescue mission for Adler, Intel pointing to Verdansk. Today, 4/19/2021, Raven Software shared their newest update. Here are the most important ones. For the fixes, RCXD has been removed from buy stations. We are able to equip armor plates. Containment protocol missiles will no longer land in play areas, and their sound effects have been reduced, and the Modern Warfare sniper scope now shows a glint. Psykov pistols have been adjusted, with their movement speed reduced when using akimbo, and hip spread increased when using Sorokin. And for the 80-round drum mag, movement speed and ADS were reduced. When you combine the 140mm auto and 80-round drum mag together, it reduces the overall damage by 25%. And now, what you've all been waiting for. Call of Duty has confirmed Season 3. Here's a look at the roadmap and what to expect in the upcoming days. We are getting 3 new operators and a younger price, also 6 new weapons. My favorite operator is Wraith. She looks badass. She has a more futuristic look for the anticipated setting. Her outfit looks nothing like the 80s, so I'm a little confused here. We're also getting the 80s version of Captain Price, but if you've had him since Modern Warfare, you'll get his new skin for free. It's nice to feel appreciated from time to time. We're getting a new Warzone event, the Hunt for Adler. I feel this could mean Verdansk is still going to be around until Adler is found. Once Wolf, Woods, and the rest of the team rescue him, I'm guessing the containment protocol will be reached and they'll drop the nukes on Verdansk. Based on the intel from Call of Duty, Season 3 officially launches 4/22, but the season goes live on the 20th for Black Ops Cold War and the 21st for Warzone. This sounds like a two-part event going on. We'll have from the 20th to the 21st to rescue Adler before the nukes drop on Verdansk on the 20th. This could bring us to the new old Verdansk in the 80s. The game is looking pretty hot so far, including the 4 multiplayer maps, vehicles, zombie mode, and all the other items that look amazing. Please feel free to check out the link provided in the description below if you want to see for yourself some of the additional items not mentioned. It's nice to see these little changes, but is it enough? Season 3 is less than a week away. Hope they don't disappoint. What do you think and feel about Raven Software's response? Do you think they're soft, or do they hold some weight? With these upcoming changes and updates, are you excited for Season 3? Let us know your thoughts in the comments below. We hope you enjoyed the video. If it brought some value or knowledge, consider dropping a like as it helps with YouTube's algorithm in doing well. Thank you for the support on our previous videos. And as always, thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, turn on notifications so you don't miss a minute of our upload. Thanks for tuning in. What Matters, signing off.